Kevin Brown and Playman are still having a lot of issues more than a month after first applying.
Emails are pouring into the problem solvers from people who can't get into the system and still haven't been paid. Fox 17's Ryan Cummings explains their concerns.
So finally, I was just watching the news and I saw, you know, your helpline there, the problem solver line. I said, you know what, I'm just going to throw a Hail Mary here. Nothing else is working.
It is a common issue sent into Fox 17's problem solvers. Frustrated workers cannot get through to unemployment.
After two or three times doing that, then it just kicks you out and it shuts you down for 30 minutes.
The phone lines are full. The chat does not work. If they do get through, they're disconnected or their filing information is said to be inaccurate.
You know, you're losing sleep. You're not eating. You're stressed out trying to figure out, you know, what's going to happen, and we're all in the same boat. I totally understand that, get that. But, I don't know what to say.
Randy Anderson is currently a live-in caregiver for his 96-year-old mother, laid off because of the coronavirus. He's tried to file every day since March 20th.
You know, I've been trying probably an average of 4 or 5 hours a day. Then they say try at night. So then I go online and I try to go at night and do it at nighttime. After 8 o'clock, I've tried it at 2 in the morning, I've tried it at 5 in the morning. And it just gets to the point where, you know, what do you do?
He gets this prompt asking him to verify his social security number and date of birth, saying the information he entered is not correct. He sent a letter to the fraud department, not sure if he's become a victim.
So all I do is I keep re-entering my social security number, which is the correct social security number, and I re-enter my date of birth, which is obviously the correct day that I was born, and then nothing happened.
Katie Curzan has been able to file but cannot verify and is facing similar problems getting through.
They said that you can get on by chat, you can send messages. I've done all those things every single day.
After waiting on hold one day, she used the callback feature, and finally, 4 hours later, a live person on the other end.
He said, however, call back in the morning to make sure that this worked. And I'm like, please don't make me call back. I mean, we laughed. I'm like, please don't make me call that number again. I called back this morning, can't get through again.
Katie and Randy both understand that thousands of people are trying to file at one time, but the money is still not in their accounts nearly a month later.
You know, when we're going to be able to pay the bills. I mean, 4 weeks is the bills are adding up.
At this point, I have no income. I'm trying to take care of my mother. I'm literally living with her. And it's just a very frustrating and exasperating situation.
Now, I did reach out to the Unemployment Insurance Agency, and I spoke with the media relations person, and he tells me that they have more than 100 people currently on the technical team trying to figure out everything that they can to help everybody. So if you do have issues like Katie or Randy, you are asked to email leo-coronavirus@michigan.gov. We are told that you will get an automatic response back, but then just wait because somebody, a real live person, will be answering your questions. More than 1 million people have already filed for unemployment since March 15th, and we are told that the state has handed out $745 million to more than 720,000 of those people. Reporting live in Walker, Ryan Cummings, Fox 17 News.
All right, Ryan, thank you. And if you're having issues claiming unemployment, call the Fox 17 Problem Solvers as well. That phone number right there on your screen. You can send us an email or join the Problem Solvers group that we have on Facebook.